Hello guys, here I have a match we played in Mordor, and it's very interesting, extra special. I mean, the game was fantastic. I didn't expect it to be such a good game, but in the end the teams were very balanced. So my team is okay, I think. Yeah, let's see how this goes. I'm not sure if this lag is from the game or maybe from my computer. Anyway, we've got Eomer here, his men, and Papillon, my good friend here, his elves. I'm elves too. And here we have Excal. And we're playing against Rubio, his Isengard, Blckeagle, his men, Messi, his Mordor, and Sauron here, his elves. Okay, there is a little bit of lag, I'm sorry about that. Anyway, so pretty much we decided to play 2v2 from one side, this guy Papillon with Eomer to attack Sauron and Messi, and me and Excal would attack Rubio and Blckeagle. As you can see, I sent my builder to make a barrack near Excal's base so I can produce more units quicker near his base and help him attack or defend whatever he needs. I mean, basically when you are elves you need a lot of help to attack. I think elves are very strong in defense at start, but not so strong in offense. Anyway, okay, Eomer decided to play with cavalry now. It's a good choice playing with cavalry because he's up against elves and Mordor. I mean, against elves it's certainly the best tactic to make some cavalry. In the meantime, I'm pushing my defense, trying to corner Rubio in. Of course, Excal is coming with goblins. Blckeagle is playing with cavalry as well. Thank you. Yeah, those guys are using the same strategy against Eomer. I'm not sure what is Messi doing. I can't see a lot of. Yeah, he has made two barracks to his teammate base to spam quicker. He has nothing else except that. So I see that he's having trouble, Excal is having trouble with his goblins because Men is helping him with cavalry. So I just brought two units of spearmen to help him. That's about it. Rubio's fort is down. It's a very risky strategy. To push your barracks to your teammate's base because you simply won't have much in your base, so if your opponents rush cavalry, they can get around the first defense here and they can go straight to your fort and take it down easily. Eomer is using cavalry very nice. He already has two units of Rohirrim and Theoden nearly at level 3. You can see Blckeagle has a lot of Rohirrim as well. Right now I want to push my defense up front near Blckeagle's fort like we did on Rubio. Papillon has already Thranduil. Yeah, the fact that I'm pushing my defense means I don't need my towers on the back, and simply because I don't like playing with many towers, I just delete the ones behind me. So Blckeagle has managed to push us back, me and Excal back. I am now bringing Lego with me. And maybe the fact that the game was so good is probably because we started at 1k, I mean 4k in Mordor. Usually the game ends after like 10 minutes, maybe 15 minutes, because it's very hard to stop four heroes going together, where in 1k you can see that everyone made his heroes in a different time schedule. And this kind of slows the game down, but not the action as well. You can see we had already some pretty good fights here without our heroes. As you can see, I have made a lot of spearmen. This is why I'm a little bit afraid of his cavalry. I mean, he Blckeagle has heroic charge, and heroic charge can kill pretty much two or three units of spearmen, even with leadership. So I chose to make some spearmen and leave one behind, like I'm doing now in near my fortress. This is what I was afraid of, cavalry bypassing our defense and going straight for our fort. I also have Thranduil now. Very nice move by Blckeagle. So it's time for us to push again. This time I want to make some Merkwood. I know I'm gonna need them. I haven't upgraded my barracks yet, but I know key point of this game is blocking your opponent's passage. So for example, if I had made three towers here, one here, and another one here, and they all had two Merkwood inside with it would need a very great force to pass through here. And if you can pretty much block one passage for your opponent, then there's only one left. And if you're attacking from this side, it's very hard for them to push you back and win the game. Anyway, this was my plan. Of course, when you're playing, things do not happen as you expect. So for now, I'm making some regular archers to have some basic defense here, and then I plan to upgrade to Merkwood. In the meantime, I have both my heroes. Oh, okay, Messi has some attack trolls. So Blckeagle here has managed to take down one of my towers, but instead he lost his entire cavalry along with Theoden. You can see Papillon has already upgraded to Silverthorn arrows. Like I told you, it's very important to do so. And I'm already late for that, but yeah, like I told you, everyone moves in his own pace. of course, Messi has leveled up Mouth of Sauron and reached him level 10. No way of saving my Lego there. Only way is to try and level him up to level 10, where he doesn't die by Mouth of Sauron evil eye. No other way, I guess. Yeah, and Messi has managed to kill my Thranduil again. I'm trying to level up to Silverthorn now. can see I had a lot of trouble from this side to hold my defense. I mean, my heroes get... I was losing my heroes all the time. I have 15 magic points yet, and I am now using the Ents to try and take down Sauron's fort. Bad attack, maybe I should have talked to my teammates first and speak with them about coordinating an attack. You can see, not even close to taking down his fort. Very bad play here by me. I somehow lost both my heroes. I had used my heal on the Ents when I tried to attack the other guy's fort, and I had no heal, so I somehow moved my Lego near the tower, and the rangers inside killed him. Then I lost my Thranduil by Blckeagle's cavalry. You know, maybe heroes are not very important at this part of the game, but there are two major step backs by losing them. First of all, you don't have a chance of leveling them up fast, and second of all, you spend all this money on trying to take them back, where you could have used those money to, say, level up your army, upgrade your army. You can see me making some Merkut here. Like I told you before, I should have done this much earlier in the game. And look at that, Sauron's Legolas is nearly level 10, where mine is, I don't know, like level 4 or something. Excal is helping me a lot with his giants. Thank you. And you can see now what I was talking about, Silverthorn. In the meantime, Rubio has got back into the game. He has his hero Lurch, he has some berserkers. He's now in position to help his teammates, either defend or attack. I also have Glorfindel. My plan here is to play with as many heroes as I can. I definitely want to get Legolas, Thranduil, Elrond and Glorfindel. They are the most powerful heroes. I mean, Haldir and Arwen doesn't do much damage and they die pretty easily. But I do want those four heroes. And I'm willing to spend some money to get them. You can see what I was talking about the towers. I mean, Papillon has helped me a lot, but you can see the point here, four towers and nothing can come close to us. Again, I'm using my Ents to try to attack Messi's fort. I mean, I know he and his teammates are trying to defend at the corner of the map, so I know his fort is probably empty. I am right, but he does have Fel Beasts. And now Sauron is attacking my fort. Of course, my attack failed, but at least I managed to destroy his cave troll. There goes my fort. Messi is using his heroes magnificently. I'm not sure about his move. I mean, yeah, he could have taken Papillon's fort down, but in the end, he would have definitely lost all three of his flying heroes. Those flying heroes cost about 2,050, 2,200, I think, to get back. And I mean, all three heroes cost around 8,000. So why try and take down a fort that costs 5,000 to get back if you know it's gonna cost you more? So this time I decide to make my fort near where my defense is. Very nice defense by Messi with his Gorgonoth's fire. He managed to save his fort. So yeah, what I'm saying is basically that some people just put their fort right where it used to be, but if you're playing a different way and you have your defense set at another point, I think it's best to use this point to make your new fort. I know it's gonna be a lot harder for them to take it down here. Anyway, thank you. So these guys have pushed us back very nice so far. I've said this many times, the Mordor fort is extremely powerful on his own for defending. It's the hardest to take and down, to try and take down his this kind of fort, but especially with Messi handling it, I mean, it was extra hard for us to take it down. So like we have set up our defense here, those guys have made the same defense on the other end, and it's also very hard for Eomer to try and pass through here. So this is why Eomer is bringing his troops all the way the other side of the map. Eomer is coming. He has 6 fully upgraded Rohirrims. He's got Theoden. Nice defense by whoever used the cloud break. And Eomer just lost his entire army. What's very important about my heroes is I need to reach Thranduil level 10 and Legolas at least level 9, so he won't die by Mouth of Sauron, Evil Eye. But it's very hard to level up your heroes so late in the game. It can be done, but it's gonna cost you a lot of resources, because you can see you keep losing them. It's very hard to protect them when so huge cavalry exists and many leveled up heroes. So Messi is signaling near my fort. I guess he's trying to point out to his teammates that they need to break our defense here. I'm not sure about that. You can see Eomer's defense, I believe, is much more weakened. You can see me destroying some towers on the back and trying to make some new ones in front of my fortress. Those guys are getting ready for an attack. They are using their magic. It's very important to destroy those catapults. Fortunately, I have Legolas and Thranduil. They can destroy catapults very fast. But here Messi brings his attack trolls as well. Very nice defense attack, very coordinated. And there goes my fort down. They pretty much destroyed all our defense here. We haven't got much left. And Teomer is facing an attack from the other side as well. Yeah, this attack was classic display of how you must attack with using your powers first. They help a lot killing enemy troops and destroying some of their towers. In late game, you almost always have to attack using your powers first, especially the strong ones. Here, Eomer managed to destroy Blckeagle's fort, but he does have one builder left. Eomer did his best trying to kill him. He used Eomer's speed, he used spear, he used his cavalry in arrows trying to kill his builder, but unfortunately he failed. His builder is still alive. I tried to send my Glorfindel to kill him. Fortunately, I think it's Eomer who used his long shot with his rangers to kill him eventually. So I believe Blckeagle only has this stable now. So finally, game is beginning to look better. I'm not sure why Blckeagle is not using his level 10 skill with Thranduil. Anyway, I am remaking my fort. I now want to make some stronger defense. I mean, it's all about where you're gonna put your towers. I definitely need one here and one here and maybe one on the back. Yeah, Eomer is trying to say to us that this is the last building from Blckeagle. Messi again uses his powers very well. Here come his attack trolls. Eomer's fort. So those guys broke our defense from the top of side of the map. This is very bad because Papillon doesn't have any defense in his fort. And why should he? Up until now he wasn't worried about defending his fort. But now he's all exposed. We need to hurry up a little bit, because if you give them this area right here, and then maybe they take down this fort as well, and they can push their defense somewhere here, and they can use all this area for expanding with farms, buildings. Of course, Eomer is trying to destroy Blckeagle's last building. He's doing a very nice job. Messi trying to cover him. But here he has done it. Blckeagle has been defeated. And now Papillon's fort is at risk. Sauron is using his ends. Very nice play by these guys. They managed to coordinate exactly their attacks along with their powers, which made them pretty impossible for us to defend. Still, it's 4 versus 3 now, so things look bad for Messi's team. Three fell beasts look amazing when they fly together. Look at that. So anyway, we are regrouping for another attack. Now it's Messi's fort we're gonna have to take down. Probably the hardest thing to do. Sauron's fort is also going to be very hard for us to take down, because he has a lot of defense. Maybe we could focus on an attack somewhere on this side, where there aren't any towers nearby. But at this point, we decided to concentrate on Messi's fort. As you can see, up until this point, Messi probably has been the best player of the game. He's using his heroes very well, he's using his magic very well. His troops also excellent, and of course his fortress defense is amazing. But these guys are continuing to push us back. They have now reached Excal's fort. Here are both 25 point magic skills by Sauron. He has used the beam of light along with the waves. And here come fell beasts to finish the job. Excal has managed to use his 25 point magic heal the Balrog before losing his fort, and he's now attacking Messi's fort. Thank you. good thing is that my heroes are right where I wanted to be. I have Glorfindel level 10, Thranduil level 10, and Legolas almost level 10. Look at how much effort it takes us to take down Messi's fort. Again, he uses Gorgonoth's fire. There's only now very little left for his fortress. I thought here that my 25 point magic skill, the beam of light, would finish what's left of Messi's fort. And here I use it, but unfortunately, it doesn't do much damage, it only destroys his buildings surrounding his fort. So again, very little left, but again we can't do anything to take it down. So this time Messi is bringing his Balrog. He knows he's probably going to lose his fort soon. Very nice coordinated attack by Messi and Sauron. Very close to taking down Eomer's fort. But look at that, Messi's fort is intact, and not only intact, but it's rebuilding itself slowly. It was very frustrating at the moment, not being able to take down his fort after all those attacks. Thank you. Again, look at this. One more time. Along with their powers, they have managed to save Messi's fort. Nice hero battle here. I've played against this guy one time, and I was elves and he was Mordor, and he used his Thranduil level 7 skill first, the Dead Eye, and he decreased Mouth of Sauron health for like about 20%, and then he used his Thorn of Vengeance to finish the job. And it was a very nice tactic because Mouth of Sauron has to get very close to see Thranduil first and then use the Evil Eye and kill him. And most of the times I couldn't use my level 10 power first. Thranduil was using his level 10 power first and he was killing me at least more times than I was killing him. Excal is bringing his giants. That's about 2, 4, 6, 8 of them. That's how many it takes. Destroy Mordor's fort. The look at this, once again those guys somehow managed to kill most of them. But I'm using my Ents as well. Finally, Messi's fort is down. Eomer kept telling us once we took his fort down to track his builders down. He opened the map somewhere in this point and we could see where Messi's builders were. So Eomer kept telling us, kill his builders. You can see he has at least two builders left. And yeah, he's making another fort already. Here Papillon used his 25 point magic skill, he killed one builder this way, actually I think he killed both builders this way, and yeah, Messi has been defeated. Excellent move here by Papillon. Eomer opened the map, they saw where he had both his builders, and they destroyed his buildings. At this point I believe Messi left the game because I can see still a Haradrim Palace. So I believe Messi left the game to give his money to his teammates. Yeah, Sauron now has fell beasts as well. Yeah, sometimes when you're playing a multiple player game, you just, if you know you're gonna lose, you just exit the game so your teammates can have your army and your resources. So we're trying to focus on Isengard Fort now. As you can see on the other side, there are still lots of towers, so there's no way to attack this side. Best way is to attack from the bottom. Only two players left now, Rubio and Sauron. I'm using my 25 point magic skill, and Excal is using his Balrog. It was about time we coordinated our attacks as well. can see how important Glorfindel is here. I mean, using his level 6 power along with his level 3 power, he becomes very powerful. He gains 60 speed plus double armor, and with his Blade of Purity, he gains 100% damage and 100% armor. So yeah, Rubio's fort is down as well. We only have one fort left to go now. Sauron is trying one last attack to Eomer's fort. And here they both quit the game. I mean, they see there is no chance. We already were playing for an hour and a half, I think, somewhere around that. So this was by far the longest game I've ever played. I mean, I don't think I've ever exceeded 1 hour before. So this is a new record. But it was a very good game, very balanced game. You could see we all lost our fort at least one time, and there were a lot of good battles between heroes, battle between armies, and also a lot of magic skills that were used. This is pretty much anything that you want to see about this game: how you start early in the game in 1k, how you use your heroes along the way, gain extra power points and use them. It's a great chance to see early game rush along with late game gameplay. So this is probably one of the best games I've ever played, and it was in Mordor. I was looking forward for that, a good game in Mordor, and here it is. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you for watching. It's been a long game, but I think it really worth seeing. And yeah, see you guys around.